First of all, if you would please take this moment to turn off cell phones, smartphones, pagers, beepers. You know what way those things can be when they go off. So thank you very much for doing that. And then just one thing, if you would open up your worship aid to page 5, Gloria. We certainly invite you to sing. We've got a nice choir of musicians here, but please sing for the celebration today. The refrain is wrong. Alright? Now many of you, I think, are familiar with it. It should be glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. The musicians will sing it, and as I said, this setting is fairly familiar. You're probably going to do it automatic. If I hadn't said something, you probably never would have noticed. Alright? So just sing along with the musicians, but recognize that that refrain is wrong. Alright? Finally, for communion, we always like to offer wisdom, consecrated wisdom, for those who would rather refrain from alcohol. So for those of you that would prefer the consecrated wisdom, please look for the cup that the bishop will be using, because the consecrated wisdom will be there. The other cups will contain consecrated wine. So thank you so much. I think we are ready to begin this wonderful celebration. Would you please rise and join in our opening song?
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. everlasting life.
Amen.
from the second letter of St. Peter. Beloved, we did not follow cleverly devised myths when we made known to you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but we have been eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received honor and glory from God the Father when that unique decoration came to him from the majestic glory. This is my Son, my beloved, with whom I am well pleased. We ourselves heard this voice come from heaven while we were with him on the holy mountain. Moreover, we possess the prophetic message that is altogether reliable. You will do well to be attentive to it, as to a lamp shining in a dark place, until day dawns and the morning star rises in your hearts. The word of the Lord.
One for Elijah and one for Moses. Ordination. Ordination of our twin brothers. One is deacon and one is priest. And you know, we, I think it's time to also look back. We might see in the rearview mirror and realize that this doesn't happen all of a sudden. This is something you might see as Solana says, blessed be God, all his designs. And some of his designs for Jason and Robert began a long time ago. I'd say with his grandparents and great-grandparents, somewhere along the line, received the gift of faith. And then in the baptism, the parents brought them to receive his faith and make them part of the body of Christ, part of this dynamic, you might say, of grace in our lives. Not just them, but also we realize that this is the plant of the seed, and the seed has to grow over the course of the years. I believe as we celebrate the Eucharist, it's a time to thank God for all those people, the parents, the relatives, the godparents, the friends, teachers, people gave an example to bring them to this point where they not just receive baptism and are part of the people of God and ministers, but now they're called to a special ministry. A special ministry in the church. A ministry of a word and sacrament. It's a beautiful thing. You know, to be able to, in the name of the church, to be able to preach the word of God as a deacon and also celebrate sacraments, give out communion, celebrate baptisms, marriages, and then do as an ordained priest to celebrate the Eucharist, to preside in the Eucharist, and also to absolve people for their sins through the power of God working through you, Robert. And also the sacrament of the sick, be able to bring God's healing in a special way to people. It's a beautiful thing. And this is, and you do this in the name of the church. And I believe too, you know, it represents with the spirit of Jesus, the Good Shepherd. You know, lots of times we come across. I think I've been studying many years and to prepare for this. And most surely you run across cases that you didn't run across in theology books. But I think more important than having augury in the head is to have that heart of Jesus, the Good Shepherd, is able to feel with the people and bring God's mercy and healing to them. And also, I think, too, lots of times that it's most some of my own experience, you know, just after being here, well, I can convert the whole world. But, you know, I think we have to have patience with yourselves, patience with others, and realize that we root for the Holy Spirit too. So, this is, I believe we also, you know, realize that we're celebrating this as you as Capuchin Franciscans, and bringing something special to your ministry. Because we find Francis was a person who was enamored with Christ, Christ, Lord, and crucified. our poverty, but also part of this Capuchin reform, a reform of prayer and poverty, and also praying for these people who are suffering. So we see, you might see two examples of men, you know, who try to, you know, live out the gospel, live out this their ministry right here in the Midwest. And so, you know, we don't know what challenges we're going to face in the next years. But we come together and we celebrate this the glorification of Christ. We come to Christ and he sends himself as glorified and as powerful. And this is the God that the good God that comes, that is accompanying and whose good news that you preach. And so, you know, we find that the church is full of people. I think this is a beautiful sign that we have to put up extra chairs. So this shows that you're coming, your people are accompanying you. And not just the people here, but many, I suppose, who can't make it. And also, it's our brothers and sisters who are deceased. And that they brought, we bring the living of the saints to all our brothers and for our brothers and sisters who are in heaven praying for you. So we pray that we have a long ministry and a very fruitful ministry.
With
charged without fail the office of priesthood in the presbyteral rank, as a worthy fellow worker with the order of bishops and the character of Dolores Locke?
I do.
Do you resolve to exercise the ministry of the word worthily and wisely, preaching the gospel and teaching the Catholic faith?
I do.
Do you resolve to celebrate faithfully and reverently, in accord with the Church's tradition, the mysteries of Christ, especially the sacrifice of the Eucharist and the sacrament of reconciliation, for the glory of God and the sanctification of the Christian people?
I do.
Do you resolve to implore with us God's mercy upon the people entrusted to your care by observing the command to pray without ceasing?
I do.
Do you resolve to be united more closely every day to Christ the High Priest, to offer himself for us to the Father as a pure sacrifice, and with him consecrate yourself to God for the salvation of all?
I do, with the help of God.
Robert, you promised respect and obedience to the diocesan bishop and to your legitimate superior.
I do.
May God, who has begun the good work that you bring it to fulfillment.
Stand.
seated.
Found worthy to reign in heaven with him, who lives and reigns with you in the
Son, by the power of the Holy Spirit, arranging them in different orders. Already in the earlier covenant, offices arose, established through mystical rites. When you set Moses and Aaron over your people to govern and sanctify them, you chose men next in rank and dignity to accompany them and assist them in their tasks. So too, in the desert, you implanted the spirit of Moses in the hearts of 70 wise men, and with their help, he ruled your people with greater ease. So also, upon the sons of Aaron, you poured an abundant share of their father's plenty, that the number of the priests prescribed by the law might be sufficient for the sacrifices of the tabernacle, which were a shadow of the good things to come. But in these last days, Holy Father, who sent your Son into the world, Jesus, who is the apostle and high priest of our confession, through the Holy Spirit, he offered himself to you as a spotless victim, and he made his apostles consecrated in the truth, sharers in his mission. You provided them with companions to proclaim and carry out the work of salvation throughout the whole world. And now we beseech you, Lord, in our weakness, to grant us this helper that we need to exercise the priesthood that comes from the apostles. Grant, we pray, Almighty Father, to this servant, Robert, the dignity of the priesthood. Renew deep within him the spirit of holiness. May he henceforth possess this office, which comes from you, O God, and is next in rank to the office of bishop. And by the example of his manner of life, may he instill right conduct. May he be a worthy co-worker with our order, so that by his preaching and through the grace of the Holy Spirit, the words of the gospel may bear fruit in human hearts and reach even to the ends of the earth. Together with us, be a faithful steward of your mysteries, so that your people may be renewed in the waters of rebirth and nourished from your altar, so that sinners may be reconciled and the sick raised up. May he be joined with us, Lord, in imploring your mercy for the people entrusted to his care and for all the world. And so may the full number of the nations gathered together in Christ be transformed into your one people and made perfect in your kingdom, where our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. bodily form which he shares with all humanity, that the scandal of the cross might be removed from the hearts of his disciples, and that he might show how in the body of the whole church is to be fulfilled what so wonderfully showed forth first in its head. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim.
One body, one spirit. with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Alan, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own.
Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassionate and merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, to all who are pleasing to you in this life and their passing from it, give kind admittance into your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things come.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Thank you.
is gone.
Over. said to me, sotto voce, pretty credible.
By ourselves. God who founded the church and guides us still protect you both, Jason and Robert.